Hey guys, thanks for checking out my video. Today, I am going to be cleaning out Guapo's terrarium. So what happened is I bought this terrarium and I had read online about the bioactive terrariums and I do want to build one and I am going to build one. It's just this is what I have right now. But I didn't put a drainage layer in and I overwatered, so some mold kind of started growing back behind one of his decorations I couldn't see. And it was growing on the mold. Well, I had treated the mold last week. It got rid of most of it. I treated it with 50-50 of hydrogen peroxide and water. And then I went over it after that with water, just used Q-tips. Yeah, so need to clean this out and I'm gonna have to get Guapo out. Guapo the Majestic. And I only have one animal in my room right now because I know he won't bug Guapo or anything. It's his Jax. He literally doesn't care about anything besides sleep and food. He's old. But yeah. Alright, so as you can see, not a super fancy holding container farm, and I feel kind of bad about it, but this is all I really have right now. I'm just gonna put it right here on part of the heat mat. It's not very hot right here on the heat mat, it's just a little warm to give them a little warmth. And now I'm going to start taking everything out. Okay guys, I got pretty much all of the substrate out. So now what I'm gonna do is take this Fluker's Super Scrub. I got it at the time because I thought it'd probably be pretty good. I now know that you can just use white vinegar and water if you want to desanitize stuff. I also have my clay pebbles. So don't buy these from a reptile store or a reptile seller, because I was looking at like a bag half this size for around $20-$25. Now this is 10 liters of clay pebble and I got it for $10 at a local hydroponic shop. Now I also bought this Reptisoil just because of the fact that it is it's ready to just throw in your isopods and pretty much go. kind of forgot the name of the other ones. But all right, so now I'm just gonna give this a real good cleaning. Disinfect everything, just go over the walls. You can see he's kind of been climbing and peeing. I try to do this at least once a week where I get him out and just clean like the walls. Obviously I didn't really get the back one super well because that's kind of where he sleeps, so I don't like to bug him, but now is the perfect opportunity for that since I have him out. So yeah, I'll show you what I did here in a few seconds. So to rinse these off, you just wanna put them in a colander, just run them under your faucet, and you see, nothing super fancy here. Just basically put them in, wash them off. Probably super easy stuff. Now you can see that it's pretty, like an inch, two, like an inch and a half, something like that. But I didn't even end up using the whole bag, you know. She's like two colanders full. Pretty good. So now I'm gonna wanna cut the screen. They say that you wanna make sure your screen drains. Well, I bought this screen, it's a window screen, for like $5. If water doesn't drain through it, I will be super surprised. And I will buy it personally for my own window. This is what I use. You just get it at Home Depot. Get quite a bit. I'm not gonna run out for a while. So it's just vinyl. As you can see, I just doubled it up just to really make sure nothing gets in there. And now, what you wanna do, doesn't matter. The screen's sticking up. Once you start placing your dirt, you can just tuck it down and then put your dirt over top of it. Just like so, and it'll be fine. All right, so I got substrate in. There's a water table. I called it a water bed earlier. I don't know why. Didn't get much sleep last night, but all nice and clean, new substrate. Alright, so everything's done. Substrate's in. Water table's in. All the stuff's back in and clean. Only thing left to do is just water it down. Give it a nice clean spray. Get the humidity probably around the 70. And put them back in. And that's it. No problem done. You can see I still got my vine moss in there. Oh yeah. All right. So he's ready to go back, and I'm ready for him to go back. So, come on, Gobble. Come on.
All right, guys.
This is Gobble the Majestic. Thanks for sticking with me this far, guys. If you made it this far, be sure to leave a like and subscribe. Also, feel free to leave a comment if you have any ideas or questions or tips for me. And until next time, I'll see you guys later.